Good evening, everyone. So, welcome to the first class of this medical imaging and image processing UG level course. So, the course code is BM3604, and we'll be having three lectures over here weekly. Okay. So, in total, we are expecting anywhere in between 30 to 36 or 37 lectures. Okay. So, I am Kunal, so I will be your course coordinator for this course, and Ankit will be your TA. So, before going into the into the course, so what I would like to share today is, what do you mean, what you can expect in this course, right? Today I will give you an overview of what you can expect in this course. So if you look into the title of the course, we are having two words, medical imaging and then image processing techniques. Okay. So how medical imaging is different from other types of imaging, right? This is one of the foremost questions. So when you do the imaging, whether it is a microscopic image or you do the normal photography, what happens is that in right field microscopy, or where you are having the light source and then the light source interacts with the object and then it goes to the detector, in those cases what happens, you are having the light photons which gains entry into the detector. Now, this light photons, it has got its own characteristics, and based on the frequency component and all these things, your color changes, right? But in medical imaging, this is not the case, because if you use photon, most of the photons, they will not gain entry into the body. Okay, if it is not able to penetrate into the body, it will not be able to divulge information about the internal structures of the human body. And if that is the case, how do you find out whether there is a pathological condition or not? So, to overcome this, we use several other imaging modalities for imaging the human body. Okay, so from here we come to the point that we are of the understanding that medical imaging modalities, it is different from the normal photography or any kind of microscopy which uses the visible light as the light source. So in general, the modalities for the medical imaging, they are categorized into two categories. First is ionizing radiations, and the second one is non-ionizing . So the word ionizing, what does this depict? It ionizes something, okay? It changes the characteristics of a particular atom or molecule, and it ionizes it, right? One classical example of the ionizing radiation is the X-ray radiations, okay? So what does X-ray does? It is an electromagnetic wave, and it has got very high energy, and when it interacts with the human body, it has the capability to ionize the atoms within our body. And when this happens, there are chances that it will alter the genetic makeup alter means it will introduce some defects into our genetic makeup. That means we are having DNAs and RNAs in our body. So what the X-ray does is that it induces some mutation within these DNAs and the RNAs, and this may lead to several diseases. One of the common diseases include cancer, right? So you may have cancer of the blood or soft tissues or bone tissue, whatever organ you name, right? Similarly, we have another type of radiations which are known as gamma rays. Which are called gamma rays. Okay, so these are also ionizing radiation, and they are also used for the imaging purpose. The only difference between the gamma ray based imaging radiation imaging techniques and gamma ray based X-ray based imaging techniques and gamma rays based imaging techniques is that X-rays are generated outside the body, whereas the gamma photons, they are being generated by the radionucleotides which are injected within the body. Okay, and due to this reason, what happens is that the radionucleotides, even though scientists try to accumulate it within a specific organ, but the organ is not a point source. It is having some tangible dimension and also the depth, right? So these radionucleotides are present all over the organs, even if you try to target a particular organ. And because of this, there is a loss of resolution of the images which are being taken by the gamma rays. Okay, so this is one of the main problem. Certain methodologies have been developed which helps in improving the quality of the gamma rays and gamma imaging techniques. Okay, now the imaging techniques which we get from the X-rays, they are usually regarded as shadowgram. They are usually regarded as shadowgram. What is a shadow? If you have a light source and then you have an object, where you will be getting the shadow? On the other side of this object you will be having the shadow. Now if you have some detector to capture this shadow, that signal you will be calling it as shadowgram. Okay, in case of X-rays, so what happens? You have a X-ray source you are having the human body, right? Then these X-rays pass through this human body, right? Soft tissues are transparent to the X-rays because they have very low density and they are not capable to attenuate the X-rays sufficiently so that it does not cross over the human body. So that it cannot cross over the human body. The only tissue which has the capability to block the X-rays are the bone tissues. Okay, so if you see an X-ray plate on the other side, you will be having the X-ray plate. Okay, so what do you get? Do you get any information about the soft tissue? No, you do not get information about the soft tissue. Rather, what you get is the information about the bones, because the X-rays are not able to pass through it. In the shadowgram, what we are seeing, we are capturing the shadow. That means light photons are not able to go through the object and fall onto the detector. The same thing happens over here in also in the X-rays also. Okay. So hence your X-ray based imaging techniques, they are also regarded as shadowgrams. Okay. There are various imaging techniques which employs X-rays as the imaging as the source for the imaging. First one is the radiograph. Second is your fluoroscope. Third is your angiography. Okay. Then we have CT scans. Okay. So these are some of the imaging modalities, right? Then in gamma ray based imaging techniques, we have scintillography. Okay, gamma scintillography. Then we have PET scan. Then we have SPECT scan. Okay. In non-ionizing radiations modalities of the imaging, we have ultrasound imaging techniques and we have MRI imaging technique. Okay. So we will be in the imaging modalities, we will be covering these things: X-rays based imaging techniques, then gamma ray based imaging techniques, then we will be talking about the ultrasound based imaging techniques, then we will be talking about the MRI based imaging techniques, how they function, that we will be looking into the thing. Then the second part of our course is the image processing. Okay. Before going into the image processing, if you look into the imaging modalities for the medical imaging purposes, what happens over here? All the images are grayscale images. Have you seen any colored images? No. Even if you have seen some colored images, those are basically pseudo colored images. That means, as per the need of the scientist or the researcher or the clinicians, they impart some extra color over there. Okay. So this is the, so basically the image processing, what we will be discussing over here is the grayscale image processing. So when we talk about the image processing, basically we are talking about digital image processing. Okay. Because whatever we will be doing, whatever the algorithm we will be learning, those are implemented in a computer, which is a digital system. So we will be doing or implementing this analysis in the digital platform. So basically we will be talking about digital image processing. So we will be having getting the basics of digital image processing. Okay. Now when the digital image processing, this course, it was evolving, at that time there were only grayscale images even for the photographs. You must have seen the photographs of your grandparents or their parents, or when your parents were just kids, so they were having black and white, not black and white, they were having grayscale images, right? So from there, when the first digital image processing techniques came, it was only the grayscale images which were there. Okay. Much later, these color image processing techniques came into existence. Okay. So most of our lecture, it will be revolving around the digital image processing, especially the grayscale image processing. Okay. So that forms the basis or the backbone of the digital image processing. Okay. There are certain color image processing techniques also, but if you have an idea of the grayscale image processing, those can be easily mastered. The colored image processing can be easily mastered, because when we talk about the color image processing, we are talking about एक कलर स्पेस, ओके, 3D कलर स्पेस. सो इट कैन बी RGB प्लेन, इट कैन बी HSI प्लेन. सो देर आर डिफरेंट प्लेन्स विच वी मे बी डिस्कसिंग. इफ यू फाइंड सम टाइम वी मे बी डिस्कसिंग सम कलर इमेज प्रोसेसिंग टेक्निक्स. ओके, नाउ कोर्स सिलेबस, यू विल बी हैविंग द मेडिकल इमेजिंग सिस्टम्स. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, द एक्सरे बेस्ड इमेजिंग सिस्टम्स, देन गैमर बेस्ड इमेजिंग सिस्टम्स, अल्ट्रासाउंड बेस्ड इमेजिंग सिस्टम्स एंड MRI इमेजिंग वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग. देन वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ डिजिटल इमेज प्रोसेसिंग. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द इमेज प्रोसेसिंग वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वट आर द डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ एन डिजिटल इमेज, हाउ यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट ए डिजिटल इमेज, ओके, हाउ डू यू गेट द डिजिटल इमेजेस एंड एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ इमेज प्रोसेसिंग एज एन ओवरव्यू. वी विल नॉट बी गोइंग इन टू द डिटेल्स ओवर हियर. ओके, देन द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर विल बी इमेज ट्रांसफॉर्म. ओके, सो विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द इमेज ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ DFT. We'll be covering it in details. Okay, for the rest of the methods, the process is similar. The process similar. Only the matrix varies. So I'll be just be discussing about how to get these matrices. Okay, this is because previously this course for your senior batch, it was a 310 course. So we could have covered the numericals in much depth, but it is not possible with a 3-credit course. We will be short of time. So we will only be discussing the 2D DFT in details, and then we will be discussing about the other transforms, how to get the matrices and all this thing. And from there, we will be telling you the methodology is the same. So you have to do it on your own. You will be getting the assignments, so you have to do the things in the assignments. Okay, then the next chapter will be the image enhancement in the spatial domain. Okay, all of you must have studied this signal processing techniques, biomedical signal processing, you must have studied. So when you are having this biomedical signal processing, what you have one signal component XT, which is given by time as the independent axis and the amplitude in the y axis, and then you have x of u, where u is the frequency, and you get from xt to xu by applying Fourier transform, right? And if you apply the inverse Fourier transform, you get to the time domain signal. Right, now when we are talking about image processing, what is an image? Image is a two-dimensional signal. Okay, over here your independent variable is the distance in the x-axis and in the y-axis. Okay, so this is being represented by f of xy. So image is basically a function of xy, and what is the variable? Variable is the light intensity. Variable is the light intensity. For an 8-bit image, the number of gray levels would be 256. So you will be having 256 numbers of gray levels. Okay, so the levels vary from 0 to 255. Now if you want to do the Fourier transform, in the Fourier transform you will be getting another 2D image, but over here now the independent variables are the frequency components u and v. Okay? So your things become capital F of uv. Again, what is the variable? Intensity. Okay? Because over here, if you see, both in the time domain and the frequency domain, our y axis is amplitude. Okay? Similarly, over here also, we are having amplitude values. Okay? So, in the so when we start with this image processing, the first one will be the image enhancement in the spatial domain. When we are in the normal this distance domain, this one f of x y, it is called the spatial domain because we are in the space, we are in the normal space, x y is space. Okay, so we will be doing the various kind of transformations, how to alter the brightness, how to alter the contrast, all these things we will be doing over here. Okay, in this chapter. In the next chapter, we will be working with the image enhancement in the frequency domain. So we will be altering the frequencies in the we will be altering the images by altering the frequency component. Okay, so if you look into the signal processing of the 1D signals, what happens? You have averaging filters. What does averaging does? It works in the time domain filter. But an averaging filter is also a low pass filter. And when you are talking about a low pass filter, you are basically going into the frequency domain. Both are interrelated. If you are designing a filter in the time domain, it will be having some implications in the frequency domain and vice versa. Okay, the same thing happens over here also. If you are designing any filter in the spatial domain, it will be having some frequency characteristics, and if you are designing any filter in the frequency domain, it will be having some spatial characteristics. Okay, but people have their own liking. They try to, they maybe try to work in the spatial domain, or they may try to work in the frequency domain. So we will be looking into both the things, right? Then we have image restoration chapter. So one of the basic example is of image degradation is, if you are taking the image and at the same time somehow your hand shakes, so what will happen? There will be blurring of the image, so your image will be shaking. So that is a degraded image. So we will be looking how we can reverse that degradation process, and before reverting back the or getting a good picture, good quality picture, we need to understand what is image degradation, what is the model. Only after you can understand what is the model of the degradation, you will be able to reverse back the degradation. So hence we will be studying the image degradation cum restoration model, and from there we will be looking how we can reverse the degradation process. In this chapter only we will be looking into the image noises, what are the different types of noises. Okay, then we'll be having the image compression this thing. So there are various schemes, lossless compression modules, lossy compression modules. Okay, and also image denoising can be done to a certain extent using the image compression technique. We'll be just going through the basics. Okay, but we'll be studying Huffman coding for the image compression technique. Okay, then we'll be having image segmentation. So what is segmentation? Segmentation means separating. So separating, in most of the cases it is about separating the foreground from the background. So we have different techniques We will be studying these techniques and we will be looking how we can segment the images. And next we will be looking after color image processing techniques. So we'll be look, so this will just be a basics this thing, because it will take a lot of time. So we'll be basically looking into what are the different color spaces, then what are the color image processing, pseudo color image processing techniques. So how do you impart color over there? Okay, so that we'll be looking, and we'll be looking into the basics of full color image processing. So this one will, I will hardly take one class. This one it will be 1 to 2 classes, maybe. Segmentation, again one class. The rest of the classes we'll be doing covering in details. And when we are talking about this application of the image processing in medical industries, basically when we will be doing this image enhancement in the spatial domain or frequency domain, or while we will be doing this image transformations, we will be discussing those things over there only. And also in some cases, some of the things we will be discussing in the medical imaging systems also. Okay. So this this you would be expecting me from the in this whole semester. The books to be followed, these are the two books which I will be following. Okay. Now next comes the marking scheme. So how the grading will be done. As you know, your 100 marks, these are divided into mid-sem 30 marks, end-sem 50 marks, and then there is a TA component of 20 marks. TA will be divided into three components. First component will be the class test. There will be four class tests, one in January, one in February, one in March, and one in April. Okay. So out of the four class tests, I'll be taking best two marks. Okay. So this will be out of 10. Second will be your assignments, 5 marks, and then 5 marks will be for maintaining your class notebooks. Okay, how regularly you are maintaining your class notebook and how you are taking the notes on the go, so that will be having the 5 marks. So this is your total 20 marks. Okay, so if you have any questions, I can discuss. These are the books. You will be getting these videos, so don't worry. You will also get the PPT. Okay. Anything else? No? Okay. So this first book, it is available online. So if you search for this name in the Google, third or fourth link is this one. So you can download this book from here. And I would, if anyone is interested in doing higher studies, I would ask them to procure this book. It is not much cost, not much of cost, around 500 or 600 rupees. So this book is basically regarded as the Bible of digital image processing. So if you want, you can go through that book. You can procure that book. Okay. This is also available in the library also. Any other question? No? Okay then. Thank you.